How aquaponics can increase our level of happiness and boost our immune system. This is what we're going to see together in today's video. Welcome in this video. If you are new to this channel, my name is Jonathan and my aim is to help you to build your own aquaponic system in your own backyard and to grow sustainable, healthy and tasty food for you and your family. So in today's video, we're going to talk about the positive side of aquaponics and how it can boost your happiness. There are different ways, you know, you can see aquaponics and just think, yes, it can increase your happiness because it reconnects you with nature and it's going to grow some fantastic, healthy and sustainable food in your backyard that you're going to be able to eat and share with your family. So obviously when you share something, even with friends, it increases the level of happiness. But that's not what I want to talk about today. Today, I would like to talk about some research that have been made on a specific bacteria that is called Mycobacterium vacci. And this bacteria is present into the soil. So in aquaponics, we have an ecosystem that is moist and we got a lot of organic matters in decomposition. So the biodiversity of bacteria is very high. We got a really, really interesting fauna of bacteria here. And we can definitely imagine that this bacteria, Mycobacterium vacci, is present in most of aquaponic systems around the world. So what is this bacteria doing is very interesting. Some searchers have found that this bacteria is actually the same family as Mycobacterium tuberculosis. So that's basically the bacteria that is responsible for the tuberculosis disease. But the one we are talking about here, Mycobacterium vacci, is actually a bacteria that is non-pathogen. So it can't give you any disease, but the structure or the shape and the proteins of this bacteria are very similar to the one that is giving you tuberculosis. So when your body is in contact with this bacteria, it's going to detect it and it's going to react to this bacteria and it's going to increase the immune system and prepare the immune system against those type of bacteria, which means that if you are in contact with this specific bacteria, your immune system should be able to insulate and take care of this bacteria, like trying to basically take over the bacteria. And this is very interesting because here we are talking about a bacteria that is completely non-pathogenic, which means that it's not going to affect you, but your body then is ready to react and it's going to react the same way if it finds a Mycobacterium tuberculosis that is very, very dangerous. So basically it's a kind of free vaccinations that you have if you have this type of aquaponic system, if you are working in the aquaponic system, or even if you have a classic garden and you spend a lot of time in the garden working with the hands in the earth and breathing around the garden. The other research that was super interesting is that they actually took some mice, put them in contact with some of those bacteria, Mycobacterium vacci, and they found out that the mice were more happy. So, you know, there are some molecules, some hormones that are inside our body and that are responsible for happiness and lowering our stress level. And they found out that the mice that were in presence of this bacteria were definitely more relaxed and divided the level of stress. So it was significant, and that's exactly what I can experience personally when I am in my aquaponics garden or even in nature, in a forest. I just feel good, I just feel relaxed. And that's probably somewhere linked to those type of bacteria that are really increases this hormone, the happiness hormone in our body. Also, they did all the research and they found out that those same mice that were in contact with the Mycobacterium vaccae, when they were put in specific situation, challenge situation, like in a maze, and they have to find the exit of the maze, they were able to escape the maze twice as fast as the other mice that were not exposed. So here we can really understand that it makes the mice somewhere smarter, or at least more efficient, more able to solve problems. So very interesting. I don't know if we can say that the more time you spend with your aquaponic system and the smarter you're going to be, but that's actually a very interesting point. So I'm not going to spend too much time talking about it, but you can go on Google and Google Mycobacterium vaccae, and you're going to find a lot of information. I put you some links in the description of the video to some studies that I found very interesting. Also on Wikipedia, you'll find a lot of information. Actually, let's go on Wikipedia together, have a look at what we can find. On Wikipedia, we can read that Mycobacterium vaccae is a non-pathogenic bacteria, which means that it's a bacteria that is not going to transmit any disease to humans. It's in the family of the Mycobacteriaceae that lives naturally in soil. So this is very interesting because this bacteria living in soil, and I saw some specific documentaries about it, and it's actually really present in swamp, in soils that are moist. So this is exactly the type of environment that we have in aquaponics. So we can definitely imagine that we have this type of bacteria in our aquaponic systems. Then they are telling us where does this name come from. So the name comes from the fact that the first time they found it, it was in a cow, in a cow dung in Austria. So it's just the fact that, yes, it lives where you got high concentration, high density of organic matters. So same, we have this in our aquaponic system. And so research area being pursued with regard to killed Mycobacterium vaccae. Vaccine include immunotherapy for allergic asthma, cancer, depression, leprosy, psoriasis, and then a lot of other disease, included tuberculosis. And why tuberculosis? Is simply because tuberculosis is a bacteria that is from the same family, Mycobacterium. So, I mean, it's not even the family, it's the same the genus of bacteria. So it's a very, very similar, and they look the same. And so if you are exposed to Mycobacterium vaccae, it basically acts as a vaccine, because your immune system is going to detect Mycobacterium vaccae and is going to boost your immune system, is going to basically increase the immunity against those type of bacteria that are Mycobacterium. So Mycobacterium vaccae is non-pathogenic, which means that it's completely fine. It's not going to attack you, your body. But Mycobacterium tuberculosis is a dangerous disease. So by being exposed to Mycobacterium vaccae, you are going to help your immune system to be boosted and to fight if one day it's facing Mycobacterium tuberculosis. So then we can read a lot of researches, and they say that some of them have shown that Mycobacterium vaccae stimulated a newly discovered group of neurons, increased level of serotonin, and decreased level of anxiety in mice. So very interesting here, we can read increase the levels of serotonin. Serotonin is a hormone that is responsible for happiness. When you have a high level of serotonin, you feel extremely well. And so the higher it is, and the less anxiety and stress you can feel as well. So
you can really understand here that being exposed to this type of bacteria, you're going to be more relaxed. And then the following is very interesting as well. Other researchers fed live Microbacterium vaccae to mice, then measure their ability to navigate a maze compared to control mice not fed with the bacteria. Here, it's very interesting. Mice that were fed live Microbacterium vaccae navigated the maze twice as fast with less demonstrated anxiety behaviors as control mice. So here, I leave it to your own interpretation, but for me, it really means that this bacteria is going to boost your ability to solve problems and possibly your intelligence. So at least confronted to a problem, you have twice more chances to resolve the problem if you have been exposed to Mycobacterium vaccae. So anyway, I leave it to you. You can read whatever is on Wikipedia. Wikipedia is just one of the sources where you can find information about this specific bacteria. And again, Mycobacterium vaccae is just one species of bacteria that are present in natural environment, especially in soil, and very probably in aquaponics. So then what I understand when I see those type of studies, but what I already thought for a while, is that the more we are exposed to natural bacteria and the less sensitive we are to some dangerous disease, simply because it boosts our immune system, it exposes us to different type of molecules, and generally speaking, it's very positive. You know, as human, we always hear about bacteria in a very negative way. We always hear that bacteria are bugs and we need to be aware from them. They are dangerous, and that's right that some of them are dangerous, but most of them are what we call probiotic. They are positive for our health. So we live in a world where we try to be aware, to wash our hands 20 times a day, to always be clean and being aware and not in contact with bacteria, but that's probably the opposite that would be good for our body. And all those research, they tend to try to show at least that being exposed to those bacteria, at least the Mycobacterium vaccae, would be a solution for asthma, cancer, depression, and a lot of disease, right? And it's true for probably other bacteria as well. So I think when you work in aquaponics, when you're in contact with gardens and with your grow bed in aquaponics, you really boost your immune system. It's really going to help your health and the health of your family. So try to be exposed to life, because this is where we come from and this is what is going to take care of us. Also, if you go on YouTube and you type Mycobacterium vaccae, you're going to find this very interesting video, which is 29 minutes. The title of the video is The Dirt Vaccine. And then you got colon Mycobacterium vaccae. So I really recommend you to see this documentary. It's really, really interesting. It's going to really explain you how the researchers found about the bacteria, how it come from Africa, and the different studies they have done about this bacteria. So again, if you have a bit of time, if you're interested by this topic, and I think it's very interesting, just go online, have a look and read about this bacteria that is really promising. You see the environment where they found it. It's really into this wet environment, and it's. I think it looks very much like what we have in aquaponics in our grow bed. You see a lot of water, swampy area in the soil. That's where we have a lot of organic matters and a high moisture level, and that's what this specific bacteria really like. So again, I recommend you to have a look at this interesting video, how to say, documentary. You will learn a lot, and it will probably interest you, and it will probably help you to go outside and spend a bit more time in your garden, because this is where you are healthy and you are happy.
So as you see, this is just one bacteria, Mycobacterium vaccae, but in an aquaponic system, in nature, we are exposed to a lot of bacteria. And really, what I really believe is that our society nowadays is really trying to take us aside from nature. And actually nowadays, human is not even considered as being part of nature. You got humans, and then you got animals and nature. And what we are doing as a society, unfortunately, we are destroying the environment and destroying what is qualified as nature. But we can't survive without nature. I mean, anyway, I don't want to focus too much on this point because it's so obvious, but it's so important to take care of nature and being in contact with nature. So when you have an aquaponic system in your place, you are in contact with multiple bacteria. And what I was trying to say is that if you are aside from nature, if you separate yourself from all those bacteria, you become very sensitive because your body, your immune system is not in contact with those bacteria. And as soon as there is something happening, you get sick. And that's what we see. A lot of people are now getting asthma, simply maybe because they are not in contact with normal bacteria, proteins that are present in the environment. So the more in contact you are and the more used to you become to it, your body is adapted to nature. Nature is part of it. And also something very important is that in the biodiversity of bacteria that are present in the world, most of them are pro-bacteria. They're going to be positive for you. So stop saying bacteria are something bad, that is something that you should be away from. You know, some people wash their hands 20 times a day, but actually a lot of studies are now showing that the less you clean your hands and the healthier you become. So I'm not saying that you should eat with the hands plenty of earth, but it may be positive actually to do it. Anyway, obviously we all need some good hygiene, but don't be crazy. And if you spend some time in your aquaponic system, don't be afraid to put your hands in contact with the water, with the bacteria, to breathe it. It's all right. It's just going to be beneficial to you. I hope you share this point of view. If not, give me your point of view in the comment of the video. We are here to discuss and to learn from each other. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. I'm going to send you one video every week. And also, if you haven't done it yet, you can have access to the free aquaponics training in the description of the video, which is really going to allow you to get all the ratio to respect the limit of aquaponics, to build your aquaponics system in the best condition, and also to manage it and to produce some really good food in your backyard. I see you in the next video. Bye bye.
Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!